Today I'm going to be reviewing the XTOOL D7W, which is the latest refresh on the D7, and is touted to support incredible speeds while working on cars due to its pioneering use of Wi-Fi for connection to the car at transfer speeds of up to 64 megabits per second, as against the regular Bluetooth that most wireless scanners use for connecting to cars. This is an all-system scanner which supports bi-directional tests, ECU coding, and we'll get to some of these demos in a bit. Now let's get this. Just to disclose here that this isn't a paid review or a sponsored video, I actually bought the D7W with my own money. However, I did reach out to XTOOL for a special discount coupon, just in case you want to consider this tool and want to give it a try. A quick unbox here, and we have some documentation. There's no hard copy of the manual included in the box. Next, we have the power cord for Europe, the charging brick, USB type A to type A cable, more power cords for the US and that for the UK. Next is the vehicle connector interface, which you can see has the Wi-Fi symbol. And lastly, the D7W itself. Really good form factor, I must say quite heavier than the D7, but it feels much better in the hand. On the sides, you have these rubberized grips, and at the top, you have a USB type A port, the charging port, and the power button. On the rear is a camera for taking pictures while walking, even though I prefer to use my phone, a speaker, and finally a kickstand, which is a nice addition to the D7 family. And here's everything you get in the box. In terms of specs, here's what you have. Feel free to pause the video if you want to get into the details, but I'm just going to highlight support for the CAN FD protocol, which you would need for GM 2020 cars and above, and also the diagnostics over internet protocol, which you would need for some BMWs and some other cars. You also have 64 megabits of Wi-Fi transmission speeds, which XTOOL claims is 20 times faster than Bluetooth, powering up the device, and we have a refreshed simple interface from XTOOL. Report houses the historic diagnostic reports. Data playback is for viewing any live data you might have recorded. I haven't really found the use of this data view in all the XTOOL devices that I've had, and so I'll leave that alone. Updates are exactly what we all know it to be. I usually just focus on the cars that I'm likely to come across, as against downloading all the updates. More has your account profile, the VCI management tab. This device can work with XTOOL's in-house endoscope accessory, and so you get that connection from this app. Like I said earlier, there's no manual in the box, so this is the link to the manual. This XTOOL here is just a link to the website. Under settings, you can change units of measurement, and also whether you want to set the USB port for data transfer to your PC, or just to use it as expansion for storage. Remote control is just for technical support via TeamViewer. And we start moving on to the business end of this tool in special functions. These are 36 as at the time of making the video. Not all these 36 will be available in every car. It just depends on what the manufacturer has built into the car and the special functions that it supports. For example, my 2017 Accord doesn't have a rain light sensor, and so it's going to be futile trying to go into this function. That's usually supported on some American brands, but mostly brands from Europe. However, a lot of these special functions will work on this Honda. For example, if I go into gear matching, you can see that that would work. It's talking about needing a hoist and all of that, which I'm not ready to do at the moment, so I'll just exit. Moving over to diagnosis, I'll do an auto scan to detect the VIN and then go ahead to select the specifics for the vehicle. The first thing I want to do is a full system scan. Let's find out whether the use of this Wi-Fi as connection to the car is actually much faster than Bluetooth. This ended up taking 1 minute 40 seconds. And this is actually the fastest time that is taken to scan this car. I recall my XTOOL IP819TP usually scans this vehicle in about 2 minutes 38 seconds. So that's practically a minute faster, or a 25% gain in speed. At this point, I'll say that it is definitely faster than Bluetooth, but I think the 20 times faster is just some marketing gimmick. It's always good to not have any codes in your car, and so I'll exit from here. Going into the engine module and into live data, I'm able to view 8 PID at the same time in separate graphs. You can also combine these into one graph. As mentioned, the device is also bi-directional, and this is the usual gamut of active tests that you find for this Honda. And just to demonstrate, I'll just turn on the radiator fan, which you can hear. Under special functions within this menu, you can also do some other advanced tasks like writing the VIN, replacing the ECU or PCM, and so on. Now, while this scanner impressed me a lot, there are a couple of things I don't like. The first is that there's no option for a wired connection to the VCI. You can see here that the VCI for the 819 has this slot for connecting a USB cable. I believe XTOOL probably skipped this due to the fact that the very fast nature of the Wi-Fi connection to the car negates the need for any wired connection. The second thing I didn't like is that I've always been able to charge an XTOOL device via the Type A USB port, but for some reason, it's not working on this one. I'll update in a pinned comment if it does start to work. For me, none of these are deal breakers, but more of a want for alternative options. Moving over to the things I like, this tool is really fast. I mean, it still has all those instances where you're going to be showed vehicle communication in progress or something like that. But on certain tasks, you definitely feel that 64 megabits per second transfer speed from the Wi-Fi. Just check out how fast reading codes from the transmission ECU is. Standing more than 50 feet away, I had no problems reading data from the ECUs. Another bonus is the fact that you can directly connect the scanner to a PC. That's a really nice touch. Some scanners are a real pain to transfer files from. Other things to like are the fact that this comes with 3 years free updates, and after that it just costs $100 for an annual license. In all, I think this is a really good scanner for advanced DIYers or for a shop. In case you're considering the D7W, check out the links in the description. You can use the coupon DIYXTOOL D7W to get an additional 8% off. This scanner doesn't support topology scans. If you want that, you may want to upgrade to the D8 or the D8W. I'll leave links to that in the description as well. Hope this has been helpful. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe if it has, and I'll catch you on the next one. Peace!